24 in Orlando. That just literally obliterated the old record of 34 way back in 1961 before the three of us were all born. A Melbourne 30 degrees, and I tell you what, good enough for a record low there. Now, I wanted to go back to Orlando here for a second, did a little bit of digging today, and the last time we were this cold, 24 or colder, you got to go back to 1989, Christmas Eve. 22 degrees, a hard frost there, no doubt about it. But the coldest temperature, Plymouth 15, over towards DeLand 22. Patrick Air Force Base coming in at about 38 degrees. The big story tonight right here in Brevard County, we're watching the big fire, 13,000-acre fire. Winds now out of the east at about 5 to 6 miles an hour. As long as we can sustain that, I think a good chunk of the smoke tonight would stay west of I-95. But here's the problem. High pressure is still nearby, so if those winds go below 5 miles an hour tonight, I think we're going to have some issues even along I-95. So we'll watch this carefully. We want you to check back in with us tonight at 10 and 11. It looks like if they go below 5 miles an hour, I think there's going to be yet another dense smoke advisory being issued probably right around 3 a.m. in the morning, just like this past morning. So the bottom line is this, check back in. We'll keep you updated on that. The other story, of course, is it's still going to be chilly to the north. There are some clouds there, but if these do begin to break up later on tonight, and I think they will briefly, we could see some patchy frost for a short time before stronger east-southeast winds prior to sunup begins to evacuate the cooler air. Temperatures outside right now, upper 50s to low 60s across the board. Afternoon highs today in Orlando, 65 degrees. In our northern reaches, there is a freeze warning just north of Marion County, but in northern Marion County, there may be a short-duration freeze. As a matter of fact, our computer models pick up on that at least through 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. Then with somewhat warmer air coming in from the south and the east off of the warmer waters, relatively speaking, we see that lift back up towards the north. So overnight low temperatures look like this, 33 Ocala, 40 downtown, beautiful Palm Coast, 37. Sanford coming in close to about 39 degrees. Average lows should be running in the lower 50s, not the upper 30s and the lower 40s. Big dome of high pressure to our east continues to build to the east. A cool Thursday morning, low 70s by the afternoon as we head into New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. Mid and upper 70s, all the rain well north and west of central Florida. Now, as we take a look at those afternoon highs tomorrow, 70 to about 75, the exception being that northeastern look. I'm going to head up to Memphis here for a second for the Liberty Bowl. Looks like there could be some showers and some thunder showers there on Friday. Game time here right around 3:30 in the afternoon. Of course, Pat Clark is going to be up there providing us with some much detailed reports. We take a look now at the extended 7-day forecast as we head into the weekend. Life is good back here in central Florida. Afternoon high temperatures running in the mid to the upper 70s. Some of us might even decide to work on our tans.